The specimen physically is Liang Hui. He is built. Big legs, big calves and thighs, massive torso on the Chinese wrestler. Feeling our process at the moment inside the opening 35 seconds.
This is vintage Anthony Do right here. Just that constant, perpetual motion. You can see the way he's never really keeps his head in that center line. He does not want to stay stationary in front of Liang Hui because he knows Liang Hui's got a big right hand.
Liang Hui on his back, not where the wrestler wants to be, immediately changes that position back to his feet, locks onto a single leg here of Do. Do trying to maintain his vertical base, does so well.
Liang Hui's good at transitioning. He likes to go for that single leg. Nice little trip right there to put Anthony Do on his back. Expect Anthony Do to be very active off his back right now. He's going to look to strike, and he's also going to look to submit.
Your discovery, Rich Franklin, what's Anthony Do.
Yeah, he was actually. You know, Lito at the time was ripping through the entire weight class of One Warrior Series, and we had to find somebody that was not on the roster at the time, went outside of the roster to recruit Anthony Do. Just to bring somebody in for Lito, and he gave Lito everything he possibly could. Great match.
Nice sweep right there by Anthony Do. Beautiful to end up on top in full mount right now on Liang Hui.
Dominant position here for Anthony Do, not where Liang Hui wants to be. Where does Lung go from here, Dragon?
You can see Lung, he's trying to turn over to his back. He's trying to escape. He did not want to stay in the full mount, but Anthony Do relieved pressure from his hips, allowed Liang Hui to turn over, and is now hunting for a rear naked choke.
Can he find a finish in the first round? It's a fast start here from Anthony Do. Yeah. Liang Hui defending against the choke that Do wants to apply, but now it's getting it a little deeper, and now
looks
it looks
like
to be sinked in. Can Do finish Liang Hui in the first round? No, Liang Hui still surviving.
He didn't quite have the position for that choke. You could see Liang Hui almost got out of it, but the choke actually allowed him to maintain that position. Good just arm control coming from Anthony Do right now.
There's still a long time to go, just past the halfway point of this opening round, and once again, Do trying to set the choke. It's all defense here for Liang Hui of China. Softening him up a little more here, Rich.
Yeah, you know what I like about the way that Do is moving here is he doesn't get static just on the back holding one position. When Liang Hui was, well, there he just lost a position, but as he bellied down last time, Do flowed right along with him.
Threw the legs up momentarily there, did Do hoping to lock on an arm. We see the side control position, cuts the hips in a little from Liang Hui.
Very active right now is Liang Hui. He did not accept that position. He managed to escape. Now you can see Anthony Do's attempting a triangle. But that's what these kind of matches are what we expect from Liang Hui, these explosive exchanges. And that's really what tires him out. It's just he gives everything into each one of these exchanges. Now he's almost got the back here of Anthony Do. Anthony Do is going to try to turn into him. Looks like a possible dope mount right here coming from Liang Hui as he's trying to cradle those legs.
Yeah, Mitch, you could see on that last lift that he did that he just wasn't in a great position. And it's little things like that that add up as the match goes on that just pull from your gas tank.
Anthony Do does a good job of recovering half guard. Liang Hui likes the half guard. He likes to drop ground and pound from this position, but do not expect Anthony Do to allow him to stay here. He's going to try to get that underhook with his left arm and try to come underneath the right arm of Anthony, of Liang Hui, just so he can create a little bit of space. He's doing a good job of framing off right now, though.
Liang Hui does have the experience, 26 professional bouts to Do's 11, despite being 5 years the younger. Still inside the half guard with 40 seconds remaining, first round of three. The opening part of the round, first half of the round, was pretty much all Anthony Do's, but Liang Hui has managed to swing the pendulum a little here, fellas.
Yeah, Liang Hui's doing a good job of keeping that shoulder pressure. See how he's keeping his left shoulder just right into the chin of Anthony Do, and that's able to keep him flat on his back, not enabling him to move around. But Anthony Do's a beautiful job of recovering full guard, and immediately he starts to attack and look to set up submissions.
Throws the legs up again. Liang Hui straight back on top of him, standing now, throws a knee off the right leg to the Chinese, threads a right hand, front kick off the back leg. What a round, what entertainment for the opening 5 minutes. We go to the towels.
Yeah, some very frantic grappling exchanges early. We can see Anthony Doe here trying to take the back, but Liang Hui does a great job of keeping himself composed and then eventually reversing the position to end up in the guard of Anthony Doe. And that just enabled him to end up on top. Very active first round.
Ace, your thoughts after the first 5 minutes?
Yeah, you know, after 5 minutes of action, I personally have Liang Hui ahead on the scorecards, just slightly. Anthony was able to obtain that back at the beginning, really wasn't able to do much with it. We saw where he was trying to sneak under the chin there, but Liang Hui was able to basically maintain that ground position after he made the reversal, improve his position. So I just have him slightly ahead right now.
It really was a round of two halves, though, wasn't it, Rich? I mean, the first half of the round seemed to be pretty much Anthony Doe, but the last half was certainly Liang Hui. Right hand, got on the outside of it nicely, did Doe. Plenty of movement here from the American. Goes to the outside lead, fine. Good left hook. Overhand right from Liang Hui. Didn't have the distance. Circling into the power side here is Anthony Doe. Got to watch out for that right hand.
But it's just his footwork. He's just constantly moving. You can see him trying to create these angles to really just sort of start touching Liang Hui. But he's got to throw a little bit more volume. He can't just have all this movement without really throwing anything.
Thought about the right-handed Liang Hui, sticks a nice jab. Jab two, hook combination from the Chinese.
That's what we want to see from Anthony Doe. Start putting that jab out there, touching him, and then getting off the center line.
Fakes the right, does Doe, cuts off the footwork. Nicely done, scoops body, head, both off the lead hand.
It looks like Doe's doing a great job of movement here, and he's working the jab, but it just doesn't look like it has a lot of power. Like, when he dipped down for that uppercut hook to the body, that right hand that he threw right there, oh, he got wobbled. Just doesn't look like he's committing to his punches.
Testing the jaw, Liang Hui. Overhand right there from Doe. Is there too much movement here, Dragon, from Doe? Does he need to settle a bit more, plant himself, and trade a little with Liang Hui?
Well, you can see that Liang Hui is trying to follow Anthony Doe. He's trying to settle into these shots. And when he was actually able to sit down and he stopped moving for just a second, that's when he got touched by that left hook from Liang Hui. So that's what Liang Hui needs to do. He needs to be patient and not allow this movement to really confuse him and throw him off of his game. He still needs to keep his game in mind.
Is that the purpose of all the movement here from Anthony, just to confuse Hui?
I think that's just his style. He's got that very active footwork style. He likes to create these angles, but you can see he's hesitating. He's feinting, but he's not setting anything else up. He's not putting out that jab. He's waiting for Liang Hui to approach.
It's interesting that you bring that up, Mitch, his style, because it looks like this style is actually starting to pull from his gas tank when we were talking about Liang Hui's gas tank at the beginning of the match.
Interesting point there. Nice right hand lead from Anthony Doe, one of the better punches from him in the second round. Good evasion there from both men. More instructions coming from Doe's corner here in the second round. They were very verbal in the corner of Liang Hui in the opening stanza. Good stiff left, just checked into the side of the jaw there from Liang Hui.
It's like they're both trying to counter-strike. They're both waiting for their opponent to initiate something. Nice double leg takedown from Liang Hui as he turned the corner to put Doe on his back, but he immediately threatens the triangle.
Inside. Oh, is there a submission happening here? What's he
nice
looking for, Dragon?
Transition there from Anthony Doe to set up that triangle. As soon as he hit the ground, he immediately threw up that triangle. Had it a bit low, but Liang Hui allowed him to make those adjustments. You can see a lot of Liang Hui's trying to turn the corner, but that's actually making it a little bit tighter. See how his legs right across the carotid artery of Liang Hui? That's not a good spot for him to be. He's got to keep that arm, his right arm, on that side of the body. Anthony Doe is going to try to bring the right arm across his body so he can sink that choke in deeper.
Liang Hui could be in trouble here. Still 1 minute 10 remaining in the second round. He is in trouble. It's over.
Yeah, I actually think I saw a tap at the beginning of that before the referee maneuvered himself around.
He put him to sleep. He put him to sleep, Mitch.
That was impressive. I told you this kid is so active off his back. once he hits the ground, he doesn't just sit there. He immediately starts threatening those submissions.
Mitch, what was the cardinal mistake that Liang Hui made?
You could see that Liang Hui started to turn the wrong way. He was actually making the choke tighter and tighter by setting this up. Watch, as Anthony Doe gets to this guard, he immediately throws up the triangle, gets that right arm above the, gets his leg above the right arm of Liang Hui. And see how Liang Hui's trying to turn to that side? He's trying to escape out the other side. But Anthony Doe just made it tighter and tighter. And you could see that quick little tap.
Just a point, there was a tap earlier on, as you said, Rich. There definitely was. Let's go to Dom Lau, make it all official.
Ladies and gentlemen, your referee has called a stop to this contest for your winner by way of submission, Anthony